Dr. Dana Peterson of Noble Clinical Research is joining us. Doctor, great to have you back.
Thank you.
So what do you do and your staff do at Noble Clinical?
We conduct FDA-approved research studies, testing new medicines to make sure that they're safe and effective.
And I mean, there's so many out there. People might be asking themselves, do we really need new medicines?
Great question. In 20 years as a family doctor, I've learned that not all medicines work for all people, and oftentimes more than one medicine is needed to treat a problem. But with the right combination of treatments, people really can feel better and live longer.
So let's talk about the specific. What type of medicines do you study there?
We study medicines for a lot of different indications, a lot of different medical problems. We nearly always have a study for knee pain from osteoarthritis. Mm-hmm. And in fact, we have three of those going on right now, studying different medicines. We have a very exciting study right now for eczema. Eczema is a skin condition where it's red and very itchy, mm-hmm. sometimes so itchy that people have trouble sleeping at night. And the standard treatment is to apply a steroid cream or ointment all over the rash 3 times a day. One of the things that's terrific about this new medicine is that it's a pill that's taken once a day mm-hmm. and can settle down all of the inflamed skin. So that looks really terrific. When people have eczema, sometimes they just have a little bit. It may be inside of their elbows, around their neck. But this study is looking for people who have a fair amount of eczema, at least 10% of their body.
And then it kind of takes over the way that you live in a way. People get very self-conscious about it. You think about what you're going to wear or how do you hide something. I mean, I think we've all seen those commercials about what people go through.
That's an excellent observation. Yes, people really can feel embarrassed if it covers an area that is going to be seen with certain clothing and so mm-hmm. on. We have another study for insomnia. Trouble falling asleep or staying asleep, of course. And this study is really terrific in that people who volunteer for this study, who screen for this study, get to have a sleep study, an overnight sleep study. This is a very expensive test that many insurance companies do not want to pay for. So even if they don't qualify for the study, they often derive benefit from the testing. Mm. For example, just a week ago, we had a man who did not qualify for the study because the sleep study shows that he doesn't have insomnia, but rather he has severe sleep apnea, mm. which is a very dangerous condition, and his insurance company was not willing to pay for a sleep study. So through our trial, he was able to get one, and now he can move on to treatment with his doctor.
Yeah, clearly a number of benefits for somebody to get involved.
And for sure.
So what should they expect when they call and are pre-screened for this, et cetera? What does a volunteer process look like?
So when a potential volunteer calls the site, my staff will ask them a lot of different questions. What medicines do they take? What kind of medical problems do they have? What are their symptoms like? And then when they come in for an appointment, they'll be given the opportunity to read a document that tells them all about the study. And then they will have a physical exam, more questions about their medicines, EKG, blood work, that sort of thing. And then after the visit, they may well have additional testing. For the insomnia trial, of course, they would have a sleep study. For the knee osteoarthritis trial, they would have an x-ray, and so on.
And you're talking about EKGs and things of that nature. Those can be incredibly expensive if you weren't doing it with them. So right. when you do procedures like that, do the volunteers have to pay for those leading up to?
Not at all. They get a lot of free treatment. All of the testing is free. And in addition to that, volunteers are compensated for their time and travel efforts anywhere between $200 and $2,500, depending on the time commitment to the study.
Awesome. And I imagine for a lot of them, there's a source of pride. It's a sense of pride to be a part of a study like this, right?
That's exactly right. I tell people all of the medicines we have because of volunteers like them. So it's really a tremendous contribution. We also have a very exciting study for menopause. For women who have hot flashes in the menopause, this is a new estrogen, and we have not had a new estrogen in decades. What looks particularly great about this estrogen is that it may be safer in women who are at risk for breast cancer, which is all women.
Mm-hmm, right.
So that's really looking terrific. So women need to have 7 or more hot flashes a day. Sometimes they have trouble, people have trouble quantifying the number of hot flashes. They think, oh, if I'm hot off and on for 20 minutes, that's a hot flash. No, if it comes and it subsides and it comes, it subsides, those are all separate hot flashes.
Right, and you can help them with that
that's
when you
right.
call.
People need to call up. It's clear that you love your work and the volunteers also, like I said, feel like they're part of the story. So thanks for being here again. Nice
thanks
to see you.
Thanks so much. Really appreciate it.
Of course. And if you'd like to learn more about Noble Clinical Research, visit their website, nobleclinicalresearch.com, or call 520-612-7860.